Go ahead.
All right. Well, my thoughts on the rising rent increases and rising house prices in Windsor, Ontario. I feel it's total bullshit for the next generation who has to find affordable housing for their families and to raise a, you know, proper living situation for the average household is not going to be what it was for our parents and for our grandparents. It's a whole new ball game, and I feel that Canada's whole real estate market in general is being flooded by foreign investors from other countries.
Okay.
That's definitely true, especially from Toronto. Because yes. Toronto investors are buying all these cheap houses in Windsor and then selling it for like a bazillion times the amount.
So you're just thinking they're creating a fake like scarcity by yes. buying up the houses from outside.
That is,
or they're
well,
just being selfish.
Yeah.
So like, what do you think is a possible solution to this?
I think there should be some sort of localized buying incentive, or at least a localized rule where people outside of the city can't invest in so much property. Or there should be a limit as to how many properties a landlord is legally allowed to hold.
Like a landlord who lives in the city or outside the city?
Outside of the city. I don't feel someone from Toronto should be able to buy up multiple units in Windsor.
But if someone in Windsor were to buy up multiple units in Windsor, you'd be fine with that.
I'd rather see the money be here, but I would also like to see a cap as to how many buildings one person can manage.
I see.
Because I feel right now people are just buying up equity, landlords are, and they're not holding themselves responsible for what's to come, for the maintenance, for the upkeep, to keep their people happy that we're renting from them.
So why do you think the market is not adjusting for any of this? Like, obviously with anything else, like if the price becomes unreasonable, it fixes itself for the most part, right?
Just, I think our living wages need to go up tremendously.
Okay.
But then so everything else goes up.
Sorry? Say that again.
Well, the rent goes up, our living wages goes up, and everything else.
Everything else will go up too, right? It's just a matter of like, what proportion will that be at? Is it going to be better or worse if we do that, right?
And I feel currently that in the grand scheme of things, the government is trying to eliminate the middle class.
I see.
And that they're only aiming for lower class or people below the poverty line and higher class people who have higher income.
Wait, so you think like the government is like deliberately trying to eliminate the middle class?
Not the government themselves, but corporations who have influence on the government.
So like, but like these corporations, don't they benefit from having a middle class so they can sell shit to them? Like how would they benefit from just having rich people and dirt poor people?
More labor. I think it'll just...
Yeah, but like, what are they going to do with the labor? Like, pick a bunch of fruits that they're not going to sell to anyone?
Maybe not necessarily food or product items, but maybe even items for military use.
I see. Okay. Well, I don't think there's a whole lot of like cheap labor people making military equipment.
No, I feel as if though, with the middle class disappearing, your average everyday job like McDonald's or whatnot, it's going to be generally replaced by electronic tellers or things like that, as they're doing at Walmart.
Yeah, they're already like starting to do more self-checkouts to eliminate the job of a cashier.
Yeah, but I think that's like kind of inevitable,
yeah,
right? That's not like no matter. If anything, I could argue that if you increase your, you know, said living wage that you're talking about, it wouldn't reduce the number of automated machines. It would 100% increase them, right?
Yes.
Maybe not 100%, but you know, you get the point. And I think like part of that is like, as much as people want to see cashiers have jobs and whatnot,
mm-hmm.
Be honest, like when you go to Walmart, do you prefer the self-checkout?
Well, I prefer self-checkout just because I don't like people.
So,
I don't, but I also feel as if nowadays a cashier is not a sustainable or living wage. So yes, it is.
Right, but then like this extends to a lot of jobs, right?
Yes.
And this has been true throughout history. This is not something new. Obviously, this is becoming a much bigger problem a lot faster than we thought because of automation. But, you know, I'm sure there were people 100 years ago arguing that, you know, people who work at the phone booth should, you know,
taking jobs from.
Yeah, you're going to take phone from the switchboard people.
Yeah,
so,
exactly.
But it wouldn't make sense, right, to be arguing for that because, like, it's dead. Like, we're moving on.
just feel there will be more of an influx of hands-on labor in factories.
I see.
Rather than behind a desk or servicing someone.
But there's going to be, like, a set number of people who are going to be able to do those jobs, right? You're not going to have infinite openings for hand, like, manual labor at a factory.
Your average press plant.
Right.
You don't need that much of an education or really skill set to work at a press plant. I feel as if there's going to be a huge influx of those jobs as the international market's shifting away. Yes, you see, you know, people in Canada and the U.S., they're maybe not wanting to do as much business or production overseas anymore. So I see more production and things like that coming back to Canada and USA. Hopefully, but our labor isn't going to be as cheap as it can be over there. Overseas.
So would you consider perhaps lowering the wages? Or
No, I think
is that not in the...
We need to have higher wages here and just respect our workers for the work they do.
Yeah, but then where's the incentive for those companies that you're talking about to come back, right? Because they'd be coming back to pay even more than what they were not willing to pay beforehand.
Oh, I don't feel those companies are going to be coming back. I just feel as if new production companies and factories are going to emerge. And hopefully...
They'll just want to pay the higher...
switch over. Hopefully, who knows?
But I see.
This is all speculation and hopeful thinking. And
hopefully it'll all turn out well, I guess.
Yeah.
But it's looking troublesome what's ahead. And everyone seems to have a few answers, none of which really hold up when put to the test. So, I don't know. I don't know what's next.
I'm not an expert, nor do I claim to be.
Same. I guess we gotta wait and see what happens, man.
My one additional theory I want to add to this is that the current influx of foreign buyers in Toronto and Vancouver and such, I feel in the grand scheme of things with our drug epidemic that's happening in Canada right now with the influx of fentanyl and other substances in our major cities such as Toronto and Vancouver, I feel that's been a deliberate action by foreign investors.
You think foreign investors are pumping drugs into
the
major cities?
Yes, I do.
So what is the incentive there? To like destroy...
Bring property value down. You just...
So they can buy up more of it?
Yes. I totally feel that's happening deliberately.
But they're clearly not winning at that because the property values are like skyrocketing, right? But I guess it could give them a slight edge.
Maybe.
I guess a gambler's edge.
Yeah.
Like in blackjack, you know? But,
yeah, I don't know. I have a whole other set of feelings when it comes to the our drug war and how we're failing.
Well, you have a bit more time if you want to talk about that a little bit too. Sure.
I just feel Canada needs to decriminalize all drugs.
Okay, with you there.
I think it was Portugal who did that.
Yes, they did.
In the early 2000s.
I would go further. I'd just say legalize everything.
Yes, it worked in Portugal. The number of crimes significantly dropped related to drugs and overdoses, and also introduced safe injection sites.
Yeah, it's definitely safe injection sites.
Well, I think we've reached that like slippery slope, and not a bad one necessarily.
No.
Of like, okay, all that fear mongering you guys did for like half a decade or half a century about weed being like the worst thing in history is clearly not true.
Yeah.
Because we're still here. Not dead, so that's gonna shift some opinions, I think, over time.